Buddies! Topic of this video now. Well, you can see it right here. This is a Honda Fireblade. What? 9-2? 9-2-9. There are a lot of different variants in the Fireblade, so it doesn't matter. All of them are very, very powerful. Okay. And one of our subscriber friend, he gave me a call some time ago and he said, bro, I bought a superbike. And I love these kind of calls because, wow, I mean, buying a superbike is a dream which most of us have. You know, we feel that we should buy a superbike at least one time in our life, right? So now I'm gonna ask my friend Kishore. Come over, buddy. Congrats. First of all, congrats on this beautiful machine. Okay. So when did you get this machine?
2 weeks back.
2 weeks back.
Before Dasara.
Wow, nice, nice. Okay, edigan techukunnam.
Mumbai.
Mumbai. So Mumbai Kelly, you rode it all the way from Mumbai?
Yeah.
Beautiful, beautiful.
First ride. First ride from distance.
Oh, so you bought it and akkadikeni you rode it from Mumbai to Hyderabad.
Yes.
Beautiful, yeah. How is she? Comfortable?
Amazing.
Yeah? I mean, this motorcycle, especially the older motorcycles, okay, I call them legends. I call them class superbikes, okay? Because these ones, unlike the new superbikes, are not very cramped. You see this motorcycle, she has got so much of room, I mean, so much of space to sit. And very comfortable, trust me, very comfortable. So you rode what, 700 kilometers or something?
740 something.
740 kilometers on a superbike. Wow, good, good. And that too, you bought and rode it from. Nice,
my
nice.
First ride on superbike.
Nice. So you said that you had this dream of buying a superbike for a long time, right?
Yes.
Long time means how many years?
6 to 7 years.
6 to 7 years. And, well, this is what I always say, friends. That is, you know, as I already said that most of us have this dream of buying a superbike, but new superbikes cost what, 20 plus lakh rupees, 20 plus lakh rupees, you know. A young person has so much of responsibility on their hands. They got to take care of their family, they got to take care of themselves, their education, their career, you know, they have to buy a home for themselves. And they have to spend 20 lakh plus on a superbike, okay. It's just too much money, right? Especially if you're buying it on EMI, you'll spend another 5, 6, 7 lakh rupees on interest. And the biggest thing, you know what happens? Very often, people buy super bikes and then, I mean, they're excited. Everyone is excited, right? They buy super bikes, okay? I mean, the moment they get a good job, they go to the showroom, they buy a super bike. But within a few months, they say, ah, my back is aching. My wrists are aching. Man, I can't ride this in traffic. She heats up too much. These tires are too expensive. And they want to sell it, okay? They want to sell this motorcycle. So they spend about 25 lakhs buying it. And they sell it for 15 lakhs or 16 lakhs. And the amount of money which has gone waste is just unbelievable. So buying a motorcycle like this, again, beware. Be very sure of whom you're buying this from, because superbikes can also be abused. Okay. And there can be a lot of technical issues. So, but if you know whom you're buying it from, if you're very sure, buying something like this for a few lakh rupees and then enjoying this motorcycle is a blessing, isn't it? Because, you know, you might think new superbikes have 200 bhp, 230 bhp. Trust me, anything more than 100 bhp feels the same. It absolutely feels the same. It is the torque which makes you feel amazing, not the horsepower. All right. So enough said and done. And now, buddy, is it okay if I ride her nothing less than 250?
No problem.
I'll be responsible. And so we're going for a shorter spin. It's traffic time. It's in the late afternoon right now. So let's roll, buddies. And before that, exhaust nut. Okay. I'll just brief you people about the specs of this motorcycle. So this is a 929cc. Okay. Inline 4-cylinder. Okay. And 157 bhp. All right. Okay. And no blah 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 electronics. Like another thing about new motorcycles, see, unless you're a professional racer, okay, that is a different thing. But if you bought your first superbike, the thing is that there's the amount of electronics that are there on a new superbike, I feel that you're playing a video game. You're not really learning anything, because You got traction control, you got wheelie control, you got lean angle control, you got 10 levels of some traction control. What all control meant? Human control, what? I don't know. Human control is not there basically. All other controls are there. So it's like playing a video game, you know. Instead of riding a new super bike with all those electronics, I would rather sit home and play GTA, you know. It's more fun. But these kind of motorcycles, you got to have your own skill. You got to have your own skill where every millimeter of the throttle, okay, you are responsible for it. Okay, so no traction control, no ABS, only human control. But do I have that human control? I don't know. All right, time for the exhaust note. And she has got a beautiful Two Brothers exhaust. Okay, we have the same one on our GSXR 1000. I know she has been missing for a long time. Okay, shall we crank her up? That's it. Don't mess them up. That's enough, right? Let's go on the ride. Let me put on my Zeus jacket and my gloves, and I'll be back in a minute. My dear buddies, you know, we gotta really respect these first generation super bikes, older super bikes, because if these super bikes were not there way back in 2000-2001, then all the new super bikes would not be here today, because that is the progress, that is the evolution. So, and moreover, these motorcycles are so lightweight. This one, almost 1000cc superbike, I'm sure it weighs nothing more than 180 kgs, because it feels so light and so nimble to ride even in traffic. This is all aluminum frame, aluminum construction, so the good part is that these motorcycles actually never rust. You could have this motorcycle with you for 100 years and she's not going to rust in most cases. And see how easy to ride she is, even in this traffic. Alright, time for the flyby. Visor down. That tack sound that you get when you put this motorcycle into this, I mean, I'll talk about that later. Too much traffic for a nice flyby, but let me do it anyhow. Yeah, so the tack sound that you get when you put most of the big super bikes or any of the big bikes into first gear from neutral, well, that is absolutely normal. Many people get concerned and worried about it, but don't worry, I will make a dedicated video of why you get that tack sound. Imagine riding the super bike in traffic and it feels so easy, so easy.
because she's so lightweight. All right, it's always fun when you're at a traffic signal and you get to launch a motorcycle. Let me do that. Okay. Brakes! Bloody idiot. I mean, these kind of people. They take others' lives. Another idiot here. All that these idiots have to do is just go ahead and take a U-turn and come back, man. That is it. To save that 2 rupee fuel and to save 2 minutes, they risk their life and moreover they risk others' lives. Okay, open throttle. There is a cop on that Activa. I thought of opening throttle and going fast, but it's okay. Pay some respect to the law. Although we are under legal speed limits right now. I know I should be using the indicator when I'm changing lanes. I mean, although this motorcycle is very, very nimble and manageable in traffic, but again, you're sitting on an engine which makes about 160 horsepower, and what is the meaning to ride her in traffic, not being able to open throttle, not being able to enjoy the power. These kind of motorcycles are best to be ridden early mornings. Leave at 6 a.m., come back home at 8 a.m. or 9 a.m. Let's scare this dude who's trying to just cross the road from the middle. No? Not scared? Okay.
I'm back home, buddies, after riding this beautiful motorcycle. And, you know, I love this look where there's all sweat on our t-shirts after we get off riding a motorcycle. Wow. Kiran.
Kishore.
Thanks, man. I'm sorry what I'm saying. Yeah. Kishore. Yeah, so Kishore. Lovely motorcycle. Ride hard, but ride safe. You know, you got your gear, everything. Very good. As I always say, get your gear right, you know. With your motorcycle, and the only thing, he was asking me, how's the motorcycle? I said, everything is spot on, except, now she's got an aftermarket steering dampener. This is a steering dampener for the people who don't know what it is. And in high speeds, when the front end, it can wobble. So this kind of reduces the wobble. I made a video about it. I'll do a dedicated video later on. But probably we have to adjust that, you know, because when I'm going past about 140 or so, 150, she's kind of wobbling on the front end. Not an issue. We will fix it. But be careful on that. Apart from that, immaculate. Immaculate motorcycle. 18 years old. So you're dating an 18-year-old supermodel, is it?
Exactly.
Congrats, buddy. Take care.
Thank you.
And if you like this video, do think about subscribing. And wait for me till I'm back from my adventure trip. November 1st, more videos coming up. Thank you. Do give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Kishore, you got Instagram or something?
No, only Facebook.
Facebook, huh? You're there on Facebook?
Yes.
What's the ID?
Kishore Roshik.
Kishore?
Roshik.
Roshik. Yes. Okay, I'll put it in the description anyway. All right. Nitin, thanks as always. Sorry, I didn't give you the bike to ride because I'm very selfish when it comes to superbikes. Well, you wait later on. Bye-bye.